The topic of this pencast is adding and subtracting decimals. My name is Darren Lacoste. Let's start with an example. The instructions for this problem say to add, and we are given 0.125 plus 422.8. Notice that the problem, as stated, is written horizontally. The numbers are side by side. One of the first things you want to do when you're adding with decimals is to write the problem vertically. When you do that, one of the things you want to make sure to do is to line up the decimal points so that one is right on top of the other. Sometimes you may need to insert placeholder zeros. Without them, you may not be able to complete your problem. Okay, so let's go ahead and try and solve this. We want to add 0.125 and 422.8. So we have 0.125. Below it, we're going to write 422.8. We want to line up the decimal points. So the 8 will go here, and the 422 will go there. We're adding. So I'll draw my line here. Notice that the 5 and the 2 are sort of hanging. They don't have digits beneath them. So we want to insert placeholder zeros, one beneath the 2 and one beneath the 5. Once we have that, now we can actually complete this addition problem. 5 plus 0 is 5. 2 plus 0 is 2. 1 plus 8 is 9. The sum is going to have a decimal point in the same place as where each of the add-ins had it. Said another way, place a decimal point beneath the decimal points that you already have written. 0 plus 422 is 422. So our final answer is 422.925. Let's try another problem. The instructions are to add. This time we're given 19 plus 26.072. Sometimes you have to add a decimal point before you can add two numbers together. The number 19 doesn't have a decimal point in it, but we know that 19 represents a 1 in the tens place and 9 in the ones place, which means that the decimal point is there, it's just hidden. We need to add it to the right of the 9. So when we write this, we'll write it as 19 followed by a decimal point, and to that we're going to add 26.072. Notice that we lined up the decimal points just like we did in the previous problem. Also similar to the previous problem, we need placeholder zeros, and we will place them above the 0 and the 7 and the 2. Now we can draw our line and add. 0 plus 2 is 2. 0 plus 7 is 7. 0 plus 0 is 0. Place our decimal point. 9 plus 6 is 15. So we write a 5 in the ones place, and we carry a 1 to the tens place. 1 plus 2 is 3, plus the one we carried gives us 4. So our final answer is 45.072. Now let's try subtraction. The instructions for this problem say subtract. And we're given 73 minus 29.31. Once again, this problem is written horizontally, but we will actually complete the subtraction vertically. We'll use the same procedures as before. Now with subtraction, order matters. So we have to put the first number first, that one will go on top, and then the second number beneath it. 73 does not have a decimal point, but we know that we can add one to the right of the 3. So we've got 73, and we want to subtract 29.31. Remember, with addition and subtraction, you always line up the decimal points. We need some placeholder zeros above the 3 and the 1, so we'll add both of those, and now we can draw our line and subtract. We can't take 1 from 0, because 0 is less than 1, so we have to borrow. We look at the next place, but that one also has a 0. We can't borrow from there, so we finally look all the way over to the 1's place where the 3 is. We can borrow from there. So we change the 3 into a 2. That allows us to add 10 to the tenths place, or the dimes place. So that 0, we add 10 to it to give us 10. Now we still can't take 1 from 0 over here on the end. But now we have something we can borrow from. We can borrow from this 10 to make it into a 9, which means that we can add 10 in the hundredths place and change that 0 to a 10. This will allow us to complete almost our entire problem. So now we have 10 minus 1, it gives us 9. 9 minus 3 gives us 6. Once again, we place our decimal point in the answer underneath the two decimal points that we've already written. We can't take 9 from 2, but we can borrow. We'll borrow from the 7, turning it into a 6, which means that we're going to add 10 in the 1's place. Well, there's already a 2 in the 1's place, so that will turn it into a 12. Now we can subtract. 12 minus 9 is 3. And 6 minus 2 is 4. This gives us our final answer, 43.69. Let's do one more subtraction problem. The instructions say, subtract. This time, we've got some negatives, and that's okay. We know how to deal with those. So let's write negative 1.05 minus negative 7.23. Remember that subtraction is just adding the opposite. That helps us because if we can change our subtraction into addition, that will probably make this problem easier to do. But to do that, we can't just change the minus to a plus and be done. That would change the problem. If, however, we change the minus to a plus, and we change the thing that's being subtracted to its opposite, we'll get the same answer. All right, so if subtraction is adding the opposite, we can rewrite this problem as negative 1.05 plus, remember we're changing subtraction into addition, and the opposite of negative 7.23 is positive 7.23. Okay, so now we have a single positive number inside parentheses, which means we don't need the parentheses anymore. We also don't need the plus in front of 7.23. We largely put that there just to make clear that we were using the opposite. So we can rewrite this as negative 1.05 plus 7.23. Now, the commutative property of addition says that we can rearrange the terms of an expression as long as we keep all of the parts together. The parts would be the sign and the number. If we were dealing with algebraic expressions with variables, we would also keep the variables there. But in this case, we're just dealing with numbers. So we can rewrite this as 7.23 minus 1.05. I kept this plus with the 7.23, but I didn't bother to write it because that's just not the way we do things with math. We don't need a leading plus. If there's no minus sign, we assume that it's positive. So we have 7.23 minus 1.05. Now, finally, we can get to our subtraction. So we write it with the 7.23 on top and the 1.05 on the bottom. Here's a little trick. If you look at subtraction in terms of groups of numbers, sometimes you can do the subtraction more quickly. For example, if we look at this as 23 hundredths minus 5 hundredths, then all we have to answer is, well, what's 23 minus 5? I happen to know that that's 18. 18 hundredths. So I can write the 18 there. 7 minus 1 is 6. And that gives me my final answer, 6.18. Thanks for listening.